Can a simple flashlight serve as the perfect entry-level device for targeted red light therapy? It's John from the Biohack channel, and today I have the Chromatorch 850 near-infrared flashlight in my studio for review. I want to mention that when you use my discount codes and links, I receive a small commission. This doesn't cost you anything extra and greatly helps support future reviews. Now, without further ado, let's take a look at the Chromatorch. Weighing in at just over 1 pound with batteries installed, the Chromatorch feels rugged and durable in your hands. The flashlight body is made of anodized aluminum construction with an oversized LED cluster head and built-in reflector. The outer rim and screw-on lens cover help the flashlight stand upright and protect the LEDs from overheating by providing a small gap for airflow. For convenience, Chroma includes a small clip-on wrist strap you can use to secure the flashlight around your wrist or hang when not in use. Personally, I remove these as I find they get in the way during treatment. The end cap unscrews for easy battery unloading and reloading. Taking a closer look, each battery cage is labeled with arrows to indicate the correct orientation for reloading into the flashlight body. It's easy to see the difference in emitter size comparing the Chromatorch to several traditional LED torches in the same price range. The surface irradiance of the light is very similar for all of these devices, but the Chromatorch has a much larger treatment area. The Chromatorch has 128 near-infrared LEDs tightly packed together in a large oversized cluster head. Light in the near-infrared range is mostly invisible to the human eye, but can appear as faint purple-pink when viewed in a dark room. I tested the Chromatorch to have 52 milliwatts per centimeter squared with fully charged nickel metal hydride batteries. In practice, there is a lot of variability in battery-powered devices, so depending on the brand, type, and age of the batteries, you may get a little more or less than this. To confirm the 850 nanometer wavelength, I recorded a live readout for my iPhone spectrometer. This is a great spectrometer for testing things at home. It's low cost. If you're interested, I'll leave a link in the description below. Like many other battery powered devices, you get a drop off in power density as the batteries discharge. To keep the power density up, I recommend recharging the batteries after 3 to 4 10-minute treatments. For dosing, I use the average power density value in between these data points. Overall, I'm really impressed as an entry-level device. It's really packing a lot of power. If you're interested in picking up a Chromatorch, you can check out customer reviews on the product page. Another advantage of this device is that it's naturally low in EMF by virtue of the fanless battery power design. Discount code BIOHACK will reduce the price by 10% and help support future reviews on the channel. Guys, that's all I have for you today. If you like this content, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and comment for the YouTube algorithm.